you do today? This is Preeti Bedi from Persona Consultants. Welcome you all to the next video in which we will provide you a lot of beneficial information on how to become a permanent resident in Canada post-study, which means when you are done studying and you have obtained a varying amount of experience also. Now it is the time for you to become a permanent resident in Canada. So what are the ways to it? How could you move forward? What do you do to turn your stay into a permanent one in Canada? Here are the two basic ways to it. The first one is Canadian Language Benchmark, which is also known as CLB. And the second is National Occupational Code, that is known as NOC. Now, let us understand what are these. CLB or Canadian Language Benchmark is a Canadian standard that is basically used to evaluate, describe, and recognize English language ability of the adult immigrants and whomsoever immigrants who want to or are planning to work or live in Canada and further would like to apply for the citizenship. French language abilities of the candidates are measured in this method, which means if you have good command over French language, like if you could fluently speak, write, read, understand French, that would be considered in this. National Occupational Code, that is also known as NOC, is compiled and a well-estimated list of all the candidates who are required in Canadian labor market. It usually explains about the desired job skills and the skill levels of aspiring candidates who want to come, live, and work in Canada under this program. It is further divided into main job groups. The first one, skill type O. It includes the management jobs quota. The second one is skill type A. It includes the post-graduation degree and it basically requires a professional occupation that require a graduation or a post-graduation degree from a university. The next skill type is skill type B. It includes technically skilled jobs that requires, you know, the certified diploma or course or training from a reputed institute. The next skill type is skill type C. It has intermediate jobs that requires a job-specific training. So here I've mentioned few of the combinations with the language skill, type of work experience, job offer, education, and other factors which could make you eligible for Canada permanent residency. So let's start with our first combination where you should have a strong English or French skill, that is CLB-7 in NOC-ONA and CLB-5 in NOC-B. With that, you should have Canadian experience in one of the NOCs, that is OA or B, 12 months of full-time or equivalent part-time work experience or combination of both. Job offer would not be required, but yes, if you have one, that can get you points for that. And education, again, that is not required. But if you have that, then you can get the points for that as well. Other factors not applicable. So this combination can make you eligible for the permanent residency in Canada. Now coming to our second combination where you should have a strong English or French skill, that is CLB-7, experience in NOC O, A or B, 1 year continuous combination experience as I explained you in the previous combination that you should have either a full-time work experience of 1 year or part-time equivalent experience or combination of both. Job offer again is not required, but you can get the points if you have one. Secondary education is required here and you will get the points for the same. Any other factor not applicable, and this all would make you eligible for the Canada permanent residency. Now coming to the third combination where you should have the strong English or French skill with CLB-5 in speaking or listening module and CLB-4 in reading or writing module. With that, you should have the experience in skill trade category with key groups of NOCB. There is a specific list of that key groups, which you can get from the Canadian website. The second is that you should have 2 years of experience within the last 5 years. And it requires a job offer that is again a full-time job offer, or you should have a certificate of qualification from a Canadian provincial or territorial authority. With that, the education would not be required, but it can get you extra points if you have one. No any other factor applicable, and all this would make you eligible for Canada permanent residency. Now coming to the next combination, which is Again, the strong English or French skill, but according to the provincial requirement. So here the specific CLB is not there. It would vary depending upon the provinces. And again, the type of work experience depends on the province, that is NOC O, A, B, or C, or D. It is all NOCs are included, but the type of experience that would depend on the province to province. And again, the amount of work experience, the duration of work experience, that would also depend on the province for which provincial nomination program you're applying for. And the requirement of job offer, that is also dependent on the province. Education, again dependent on the province. And any other factor not applicable, and all this would make you eligible for the Canadian permanent residency. The last combination is where you've kept like strong English or French skill with CLB4. And with this, you do not require any type of work experience. You do not require any type of job offer. And I'm really sorry, you do not require any type of amount of work experience. A minimum work experience requirement is not there. But you must have a job offer in the NOC O, A, B, or C. Together with that, you must be graduated with a publicly funded post-secondary institute in Atlantic, and the program should be of 2 years minimum, and the job offer again must be from the Atlantic employer. So this combination can also make you eligible for Canada permanent residency. So, dear friends, Persona Consultants have more than 13 years of work experience of handling work in Canada cases. We have 99% success rate with 100% client satisfaction ratio, not only in Canada, but we deal in across countries, 30 countries with a blooming client network. Therefore, you can also approach us too by visiting us at our headquarters in Jalandhar, that is second floor, AK Empire, near BSF Chonk, Jalandhar. And if you are located far away, you can call us at 85660-28008 and talk to us regarding your further guidance for work in Canada cases. Do not forget to follow us on Facebook, YouTube, Twitter, Instagram, and LinkedIn, where we post our daily updates for you on study programs, on study visa, and the ways with which you can be, you know, settled down in foreign countries with your study. So thank you so much. Take care. See you soon again with a lot of information. Bye-bye.